ever hear of Phil Schneider? He tried to do what I'm doing, but he didn't know the entirety. Anderson Cooper, is that cloning? Yes. Listen, Elijah Wood didn't mind being used when he was a kid for benefit.
Money, right? Fame.
That's what most of them do.
Yeah.
If they ever try to talk.
Which he's doing now. I mean, don't you think he...
He took it back. He took it back and said that he didn't even mean it. He said he was elaborating on someone else's article, and they took it out of context. But that was just a lie because they bounced time. And they said, take it back or we're going to kill you. That's what they do. That's why no one can talk, because they bounce time. They have time bounce tech, like the Groundhog Day effect. With Bill Murray, they can do it a day or a week, whenever they made the pass land. And Elijah Wood knows all about me. All about cloning. I've met him and talked to him there. Same with Pink the singer. I'm just using her as an example. If she comes out tomorrow on national, international live television and says, there's a cloning center and they're killing people. They use us as slaves and we can't say anything. Do you know what they do? We will again. Go back to 3 days ago, to the last proton slam of CERN Hadron Collider. I don't know how the science works. I'm not a physicist. They will go back to 3 days ago, and guess what happens to Pink? Pink gets shot. Pink gets shot 3 days ago. I'm kind of frantic, because look at the lengths that I have to go. Not an insult, but it should be CNN.
There's another aspect to this. It's the lizard part. Now, I have to put this eloquently, because they said that this is the end of the world event. This is the big bomb that could send the world into panic and loss of order. Well, they're not shapeshifting. The thing is, I'm going to tell you what the shapeshift is, and it's really creepy. And this is the thing that they said that could wipe the world. People panicking with the riots and stuff, because the cloning thing, people cloning people's kids, messing them up in the brain is bad enough. The lizards. Okay, lizards been around a long time, like since before ancient Egypt and everything. And the symbol, you know, that eye, the eye of Horus with the squiggly hanging out of it, has to do with lizards. It's a lizard symbol. It means two things. It's a pro-lizard symbol, and it also means beware, there's lizards here. Okay, there's three different kinds of lizards. I'll tell you all about them. They're called Vril. Germans were into them. They had a club with Vril things. Anyway, there's like a 1 to 1.5 foot tall one. That's the Vril type one. It's got scales, red scales. There's a type two that is not parasitic, but it's still vicious, nasty, carnivorous. They're all carnivorous. And there's a type three that's 8 feet tall that has a real long neck and looks like a gray alien. But it comes from deep, deep, deep underground. Below deep base. Now I have to tell you about the parasitic aspect of the lizards and why the Illuminati and the governments use them, okay? I'm saying this in a nutshell. Well, the lizards have a thing, okay? They have what's called a proboscis. There's lizards out there today that have a proboscis on their face, okay? These things got it in the middle of their head, okay? And on the top of their head, this is the real type 1 and 2. The type 2 have a proboscis sheath that comes out. It sticks out. The type ones, for instance, it's like a a chocolate chip. It looks like basically the tip of it. Now, at one point in these things' lives, because they have a long lifespan, the lizard species, one point in their life, they slowly wiggle this thing out, eject it, and it goes into somebody's eyeball, okay, another animal. Now, it wiggles in by the sense of taste. They described this to me so, like, when I was like 18 years old there, the lizard, okay, the thing squiggles in through the eye. It does a spiral around the optic nerve all the way to a certain point, and it's driven there by taste. And they said once it gets there, it has the taste of butterscotch, and then it does a feeling like holding your breath and going, pushing outwards. And at the tip of this chocolate chip, it then starts what they call sweating the quill. Now, the spinal cord stuff comes out of the spinal cord, out of the chocolate chip thingy, and it's everything that the lizard is. The lizard's whole body is dead. The little lizard thing is dead. And it can't go back in. Can't get it back in. It's one way. Once it excretes this stuff, sweats this quill thing, the person's debilitated for an unknown amount of time. I don't know how long. But when they come back, they have to have some recovery time. But when they come back, they are not the person anymore. They are then the lizard. Let me put this to you flatly. The old person's consciousness is gone. The body is absolutely, totally dominated, and the lizard is smarter as a human then, and totally controls everything. Over time, it'll develop a rash, it'll lose its hair. Thing is, these things are all over the place, and they mimic human behavior. In fact, one of their names in the past is Mimic. A lot of the people that you hear about in the news that are getting people and chopping them up in the basement and eating them and stuff, frying them up, these are what they call drones. They're parasitic hosts of the lizards. They like to make them. The only thing a drone wants to do is make more, have sex, and torture someone. Like, it's a different kind of mentality. It's hard to explain. When they at the cloning station, when they victimize someone, it gives them a powerful feeling, as they said that this is the end of the world event. This is the big bomb that could send the world into panic and loss of order.